What's up, everyone? I'm EmParallax here, bringing you hour one tips and tricks for the new tactical turn-based strategy, BattleTech. I hope this information will help you hit the ground running to keep your mechs from becoming a pile of scrap. Let's dive right in. My first tip is to disable movement animations, which will really help you increase the tempo of the gameplay in battles. Now, I know you would all love to appreciate the beautiful graphics by strolling through the battlefield in your mech. However, I'm of the opinion that I'd rather take that time watching animations to see my lasers and missiles rip enemy mechs into pieces. However, it is all a matter of personal opinion. But here's how we're going to change those settings. First, you are going to want to navigate to the settings screen by hitting Escape and then Settings. Next, you want to find the scroll bars that control the normal follow cam and sprinting follow cam, which can be seen right here. All you have to do is slide those two bars all the way to the left and where it says Never, and you won't have to worry about any of those animations anymore. Number two is pay attention to the mission dialogue. If you're anything like me, you usually just skip through all the dialogue, skip all the cutscenes, and you just want to get to the battle, you just want to get to the action. However, I'm going to caution you that there's a lot of good tactical information that they go ahead and tell you if you fully read or listen to the mission dialogue. So just doing some quick math here, we have two options, and one option you have to deal with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 turrets for two portions of the mission. So I'm not going to do too many spoilers other than that. Just make sure you read the dialogue because it will help you in the future. My next tip is just the basic understanding of combat mechanics, such as range and hit percent. In the bottom right, you'll see not only each of your weapons, but the percentage that your weapon will hit an individual target. That percentage is based on not only the distance from you to that target, the range of your weapon, and also your point of view, and if there's any obstructions blocking your way. Next, let's talk about range. As you can see, there's an arc projected in front of your mech in which direction it can turn. That denotes kind of the range of your weapons and how effective they'll be. So you can also check the range of your weapons by hovering over each weapon and right clicking, and it will give you a little bit of information along with the range. So when choosing a target, you're going to want to make sure that you only pick the weapons that actually have a chance of hitting. Not only does firing weapons that have no chance of hitting waste ammo, if there is ammo for that weapon, you end up looking like this guy. And now to our fourth topic, basic heat management. This mech is red hot and not in a good way, so let's see what we can do to prevent your mechs from looking like this. Rewinding, let's take a look at what he did wrong. First, he uses jump jets or thrusters to epically enter the battle. He then proceeds to unload everything he has at my mechs. So he literally jumps in, guns blazing, but doesn't pay attention to his heat. His mech gets so hot, it basically completely shuts down, rendering him useless. I then make short work of him. Okay, so let's say you have a couple of targets in your weapon range and you just can't pick which one to fire on. Well, you're in luck because in BattleTech, you can click the multi-target button and spread the love in the form of lasers, missiles, and ballistic fire to each individual target. All you have to do is select which weapon you want to fire on which target and then just sit back and watch the fireworks explode. I'm going to have a little bit of fun by showing you how important structure and armor are to the well-being of your mechs. So let's take a look at the enemy real quick. In the sectional diagram of the mech, you can see the left side is white, meaning it still has some armor left, but his right side is exposed structure. So let's see what happens when I take some pot shots at him. As you can see, I physically can destroy both of his arms. So really, any component or section of your mech can be destroyed when the armor is destroyed, and then you reduce the structural hit points to zero. So those, destroying each section will reduce the functionality of that mech. So you could destroy arms and the weapons associated with those arms, or legs, making your mech or the enemy mech fall over. So you really don't want to be this guy where your legs and arms are almost all destroyed and your face gets curb stomped. So let's watch the armor. The last trick I have for you mercs to hit the ground running in your mechs is to use the environment to your advantage, whether that be using a source of water to cool off an overheated mech, maybe it's using high ground to halt an advancing enemy. Also, make sure positioning and line of sight are extremely important. If you have a view of the enemy and they have an obstructed view, that means your firing solution is going to be a lot stronger than theirs. So putting all this together, make sure that you can take every advantage you can in BattleTech to give you the edge. EmParallax here, and that is all I have for you today. I am extremely addicted to BattleTech and can't wait to dive deeper into the story and release more guide and gameplay content for you all. If you enjoyed your time here, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and remember, it is all about how you look at things.